Jerusalem is one of the most world-famous cities. The city is a holy site for Christians, Muslims, and Jews at the same time. Within the old city's fortress walls that we are flying over right now, we find the most important shrines of three religions. One of them is the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Tradition has it, it was built on the site where Jesus Christ was crucified, buried, and then resurrected. The church is home to a piece, biggest in the world, of the true cross, the tomb, and other venerable relics. In 1009, the church was destroyed by order of a Fatimid caliph, which set the stage for the Crusades. In the mid-12th century, the Crusaders rebuilt the church in a majestic Romanesque style. In 1808, the church was damaged by a fire, but then was reconstructed and regularly renovated. Surrounded by a wall, but only a part of it has survived until now. This section is comprised of 45 layers of stone and is 32 meters high, with 19 meters of them above the ground. The remaining fragment is 488 meters long, but only a 57 meter long section is known as the Wailing or Western Wall. The rest is hidden from view by houses. Over the centuries, the Wailing Wall has been regarded as a symbol of faith and hope of many generations of Jews. Believers and pilgrims who come to Jerusalem leave notes in the cracks between the wall stones with prayers and requests to God. Nearby, behind an arch, there is a library with religious texts. Look at the floor. Its glass fragments let you see how deep underground the base of the wall is. Now we are heading towards the Mount of Olives. Once it was covered with olive groves. On its western and southern slopes lies the old Jewish cemetery. Among its 150,000 graves are believed to be those holding the remains of Absalom and other Old Testament figures. The Damascus Gate. In the first century BC, it was the main entrance to Jerusalem, and now it is the main gate of the old city's Muslim quarter. Atop Mount Zion, outside the walls of the old city, is the Cenacle, a room on the upper floor of a Jerusalem building where tradition says Jesus had the last Passover with the disciples. Tourists may enter the building and enjoy looking at the city from its roof. What you see now seems to be an ordinary narrow street in the old city, one of many, with shops, cafes, and tourists. Yet, it's another holy place and landmark of Jerusalem, Via Dolorosa, sorrowful way, from Latin. It is said to be the path that Jesus walked on the way to his crucifixion. This 650-meter-long fragment is marked by 9 stations of the cross. Right now, the tourists are taking a picture of one of these holy stations, the place where Simon the Cyrene was ordered to take Jesus' cross and carry it to Calvary. One of the churches in Via Dolorosa is the magnificent Lutheran Church of the Redeemer. It was consecrated in 1898 in the presence of Kaiser Wilhelm II. In 1989, the Museum of the History of Jerusalem was opened in the ancient citadel, not far from the Jaffa Gate, the Tower of David. It is one of the most visited sites where one can learn more about the city and feel the atmosphere of the mythological times. Our trip is coming to an end. A short video cannot show you all of Jerusalem's landmarks and attractions, but even a brief tour can help form an impression about this absolutely incredible city. Let us have another look at it from above and venerate its contribution to the history of mankind.